Hi, I'm Amy, and this is House of Nash Eats, and today we are making my best easy banana bread. I do it all in one bowl with one spoon. That's it, because I'm lazy and I don't want to do extra dishes. So I'm gonna show you how I do it every time. I'm gonna start by melting butter in my bowl, and then I'll mash the bananas in it. So I'm gonna melt this real fast. Be right back. So I've got the melted butter in my bowl, and now I'm just going to take my bananas and mash them up. So these are what I like my bananas to look like when I'm making banana bread. They should be nice and brown, lots of spots. I always seem to have these sitting on my counter because my family, sometimes they love bananas and I can't keep enough of them. And other times I buy too many and we end up with lots of brown bananas. So this recipe uses 3 to 4 bananas. Kind of depends on what size they are. If you have really big ones, like these are pretty big, I'm just going to use 3. If they're smaller, you can use 4. I like using banana bread recipes that use lots of banana in it so that I can use up the bananas without making 6 loaves of banana bread. So I'm going to peel the bananas. And the reason you want to use nice brown bananas is it gives the bananas time for the sugars to develop, so it'll be a nice sweet banana bread and they'll be nice and soft. So now I'm just going to use a fork to mash up the bananas in the butter. Once the bananas are mashed, they don't have to be pureed, just they can be a little chunky still, but you mostly want to mash them up. They're going to be mixed in with the butter pretty well. Now that we have the bananas mashed in with the butter, we're going to add the sugar, the egg, and the vanilla. So I'm using just 3/4 of a cup of sugar. I feel like that's just the right amount of sweetness with my bananas when they're nice and ripe. They have their own natural sweetness, so you don't need too much sugar. 1 egg and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. And I'll include a link to the recipe below, which has all the measurements for you. And then I'm just going to use a wooden spoon to stir it all together. So the next thing you're going to do is add the flour, the baking powder, baking soda, salt, and cinnamon. Now, you could whisk these all together in a separate bowl. I'm just going to skip that step. And the way to make sure it still gets all evenly combined is by sprinkling the ingredients over the wet ingredients in your bowl. So I'm just going to sprinkle the baking soda and baking powder. And that's just 1 teaspoon of each of those. And then it's 1/8 teaspoon of salt and 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. I don't want it too cinnamony. I feel like that overpowers the banana flavor, but just a little cinnamon brings out the warmth. And then we're going to add 1½ cups of all-purpose flour. And then just use your spoon to stir it up until it's combined. Making a quick bread like this is a lot like making muffins. You don't want to over-combine your ingredients or use a hand mixer because it will just make for a denser, tougher bread. It stays nice and light if you just use your arm power and stir it with a spoon. Plus it saves you getting extra things dirty. Okay, when you can still see some of the flour remaining, that's the time to add nuts or chocolate chips or any other mix-ins that you want to add. So I love banana bread with walnuts, but my family loves it with chocolate chips, and it seems like that's what a lot of people really like. So I've got both right here. Today I'm going to do chocolate chips for my family. Tell me in the comments below which you prefer to mix into your banana bread. I've got 1 cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips. You could use dark chocolate or milk chocolate, or you could use peanut butter chips or those cinnamon chips. Those would be really, really good. So there's lots of different things that you can mix into this base banana bread recipe. And you just stir it until those chips are evenly dispersed and make sure that there's no flour left in your bowl. Okay, that's all there is to it. So now we're going to spray a loaf pan. So I've got my I think this is a 9x5 inch loaf pan, and you could use a slightly bigger or slightly smaller loaf pan. It might just affect your bake time just a little bit. So I'm gonna use baking spray. You could also line your pan with a parchment paper sling so that it's easy to get the banana bread out when it's done. And then just pour your banana bread batter into the pan. And you could sprinkle some extra chocolate chips on top, some extra walnuts, whatever you're using, just to decorate it. I'm just gonna do it plain like this for today. So then it just goes in the oven for about 50 to 60 minutes until a toothpick or skewer or knife inserted in the center of it comes out clean. Okay, so here is my banana bread, and it smells so good. I love when it's fresh and warm from the oven. It needs to cool for about 10 minutes, but once it's cooled, then we can turn it out and cut into it. Okay, so this is cool enough to handle now, so I'm just going to turn the loaf out, and it'll slide right out if you've properly greased your pan, and then we can cut off slices of our banana bread. You can see that the banana bread is nice and filled with chocolate chips in this. It's got a wonderful texture, just a hint of cinnamon for that warmth. The banana flavor really comes through. It's so, so delicious. This banana bread tastes so good. My family loves it. It freezes really well, so you can cut the slices and freeze them individually for quick and easy breakfasts. You can eat the whole loaf. You can double the batch. Send another loaf of bread to a friend. So it's great for sharing. It's a great way to use up those leftover brown bananas that are overripe and have been sitting on your counter for too long. Okay, I'm gonna take a bite of this banana bread. And my favorite part is the corner on the top. I don't know why that's my favorite, but it's my favorite like texture in the whole banana bread. Okay, it's so good. You really get the banana flavor. The cinnamon's not overpowering. It's good with the chocolate. I love it with walnuts too. So try it both ways. Tell me what you like best. If you like this banana bread video, be sure to like and subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell. And let me know in the comments below what you would like to mix into your banana bread.